Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us see how to generate remote code coverage with Jacoco Maven plugin and SonarQube server. In our earlier videos, we have seen how to quickly set up the SonarQube server with the bootstrapped configurations, also how to generate the code coverage report locally with Jacoco Maven plugin. Refer to this video URLs for more details. The first one is set up SonarQube in a Docker container and bootstrap the quality configuration. And another one is code coverage report with Jacoco Maven plugin and SonarQube in Docker. In this video, we are going to see how to generate the code coverage report for the application running in the remote server, that is remote JVM. I have a sample web application deployed to the Tomcat server. So this is a sample application. I have a sample servlet.java. DoGet method with a simple code. There is a condition if request.get parameter input not equal to null. Then appending that value, input value to the output. Otherwise, I'm just sending this welcome to sample web application. I'm using the extended Tomcat Docker container to deploy this application. This is the Docker container configurations. I will be posting this link in the video description. Tech Forum repo, Docker projects, Tomcat extended. I have a Docker file, then the agent jar, Jacoco agent.jar. And also I have a Docker compose.ml file. Then there is some Tomcat related extension. So if I go to the Docker file, I'm just copying that agent jar, Jacoco agent.jar to this location. Also there is some other additional configurations. Now if I open this Docker compose.yaml, yeah, here I am using that image, specific image, tech forum, Tomcat extended latest. Then I am specifying some agent, Jacoco agent related configurations where my agent jar, then port number 6300, then address. I'm accepting the request from all the IP address because the server is running inside the Docker container. This is must, otherwise the agent will not accept the connection. Then destination file where it should be exporting the data. Then includes, I'm going to include only my package, Java package, com.sample. If you want, you can specify star that it will include all the packages running in the server. Also you can add multiple packages. Then append equal to true. So I want to append the reports every time. Then output equal to TCP server. When I am deploying this specific application, code coverage remote.var sample application on the server startup. So what you can do is you can just check out this project and you can go and run this specific command, Docker compose app. It will start the server. Also you should be able to access the specific application. The output TCP server means the agent listened for incoming connection on the TCP port and write the execution data to the TCP connection. There are different output types. File, this writes the execution data to a file on the VM termination. The next one is TCP client. Here agent connects to the TCP port and the address specified and write the execution data to that TCP connection. Let us now review the Jacoco Maven plugin configuration in the project. So if I go to the project pom.xml, the Jacoco plugin version is 0.8.6. Then we configured some executions. So the first one is dump. The phase is post integration test. Then goal is dump. Here we are specifying the agent address, the agent running on Tomcat server, address localhost. Then where this file should be downloaded in the local system. We are saying this target folder, then the file name is jacoco.exec, then port number, the agent port number is 6300. Reset equal to false means the data will be resetted in the server after downloading the execution data. Then append equal to false or true. Another execution to generate the report based on the execution data downloaded from the agent. If you see your face, verify, then goals, report. I'm not enabling other Jacoco plugin related configurations like prepare agent, as the reason is I am not having any test classes enabled in this project and going to generate the report based on the execution data downloaded from the remote agent running on the Tomcat server. I'm going to use the manual testing for generating this report, but you can enable the additional unit integration and functional test coverage in this project and merge the report from the remote server. I have already started the SonarQube server. Let me start the Tomcat. This is the folder. I cloned the project. If I sue ls, yeah, I have all those files. Now let me run this command, docker compose up. This will start the Tomcat server and enable the Jacoco agent and also deploy the sample application. But even whenever you modify the application, you can just place that over here, Tomcat extended. You can replace this code coverage remote.var so that it will be auto deployed, because this var file is already mounted to the Docker container Tomcat server. Yeah, now the server is up and all the applications are deployed. Let me quickly test the application. Code coverage remote sample. This is the servlet. Yeah, welcome to sample web application. Then let me now generate the report. If I go here, I'm going to execute this command mvn clean verify sonar colon sonar from this specific folder, code coverage remote. So let me execute. The execution is completed now, but if you see here, it's saying connecting to localhost 6300 agent, then dumping execution data to this specific folder, then generating the report based on the downloaded data, jcoco.exec. So yeah, analyzed bundle, code coverage remote with own classes. Let me quickly open the local report, code coverage remote target, then site, jcoco, then index.html. Yeah, the code coverage is 76%. I will be able to see the detail, sample servlet. Yeah, this is covered, but if I go to do get, so this particular branch is not covered because we are not passing any input parameter here. So even I can go and test it again, just passing this parameter. Input, yeah, I will pass some parameter saying test. I will do the test, then again I will go and generate the report. If I go here, yeah, again I will do that. Let me open the report again, index.html. Yeah, this time if you see, it is 100%. If I go to the details, sample servlet, both the branches are covered and also the instructions are covered. So it means it's 100%. Even now the report is uploaded to SonarQube server. If you see here, code coverage remote, the project coverage is 100%. If you click here, yeah, you can see here again 100%. Let me open that sample servlet.java. Yeah, you can see it's all the branches and instructions are covered. Let us now quickly see how to view the report through Eclipse. So for that, as a first step, we should be enabling the ECLMR plugin. So help Eclipse marketplace, ECLMR, install this plugin. Let us now import the execution data, go to file, go to import, then search for coverage session, then click on next. Here you have different options. Data file, you can directly select the data file what you already downloaded, or even you can use the data URL or agent address. I am going with this port number 6300. Even you can select this reset option if required. Now click on next. Yeah, here you need to select the project where this classes and Java files are available. So select this project, click on finish. Now you can see the report over here. Just click on this, it's again 100%. Click on sample servlet.java. You can see all the details here. Even you can use the Jacoco CLI to generate the report. The CLI can be downloaded from this GitHub repository, Jacoco 08.6.zip. Even if you want, you can download other versions also. You can see this Jacoco CLI.jar file here. So along with this Jacoco agent.jar, this one we used earlier. So we are going to use this Jacoco CLI to generate the report now. We are going to execute these two commands. One is dump jacoco cli dot jar, then dump, then address localhost, then port 6300, then destination file where this would be exported, jacoco.exec. If you want, you can specify reset. Another one is generating the report based on the exported data. If you see here, report jacoco.exec, that is the file. Then we should be specifying the class files. So this is my project location, target classes. The classes should be generated before executing this command. It means the project should be built so that the class files will be generated. Even we should be specifying the source file. So otherwise, if you are not specifying the source file, you will not be able to drill down into the report and see the details. Then HTML, this is the directory where the HTML report should be stored. Then XML, if required, even you can generate the XML report. Let me quickly execute the command. I'm removing this reset. Fine. Yeah, now it's connected and dumped the data. Let me generate the report now. Okay, analyzing one classes completed. If I go here, yeah, CLA report folder is created and there is a file called index.html. Let me open that. Yeah, it's 100% again. Open that. I'm able to drill down to the report. So if I open this, yeah, it's saying like it's 100%. All the instruction and the branches are covered. Even this created a file called jacoco.xml. Even for this class files option, you can directly point to the var file or the jar file contains the classes. Yeah, please note the class version between the server and the project should be matching. Otherwise, you will receive this warning. Do not match the classes in bundle code coverage remote do not match with the execution data. Means the server version and the project version is different. So always deploy the latest code to the server and run the test and execute the report. For the Tomcat server outside the Docker container, just add this Java agent configuration as part of this Java OPTS. Catalina.bat or Catalina.sh file based on your platform. The remote code coverage is very useful to generate the end-to-end code coverage report for the application running on remote server. The remote agent running on the server instrumented the classes invoked and created the execution data. The execution data can be downloaded to generate the code coverage report. That's all for today. Thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.